दिस क्वेश्चन टॉक्स अबाउट एन इन्वेस्टर चिंतामणि हु मेड एन इन्वेस्टमेंट ईयर अगो इन थ्री डिफरेंट सेक्टर्स टेलीकॉम इंश्योरेंस एंड रिटेल इन टू कंपनीज ऑफ ईच सेक्टर. द प्राइजेज आर गिवन एज ऑन 5 जून 2006 एंड 5 जून 2007 एंड इन ईच कंपनी ही बॉट शेयर्स इन द मल्टीपल्स ऑफ 10 ओनली. If I read the question, I see that the question is talking about the percentage change and the absolute change in the share value of each share. So to solve this, what we can do is that first of all we can start calculating two basic things, that is the change in the absolute value of each share during the 1 year period and the percentage change. If I look at the companies A, B, C, D, E, and F, the price change in A is 80, in B is 75, in C it is 120, in D it is 40, in E it is 100, and in F it is 70. If I look at the percentage change, I can see that 80 upon 150, that is 8 by 15. Again, one need to be good with reciprocals and fractions. It will turn out to be 53.3%. 75.500 is easy, 15%. 120.200 is again easy, 60%. 40 upon 400, very easy, 10%. 100 upon 800, that is 1 by 8, very easy, 12.5%. One should always remember these reciprocals. 70 upon 175, again easy, 40%. So these are the absolute changes and the percentage changes in the six companies. Now look at the question. If the shares that witness the top two absolute changes in their prices belong to telecom sector, it's talking about absolute changes and top two. I can see that he's talking about company C, that means this company belongs to telecom sector, and he's talking about company E, this belongs to telecom sector. While the shares that witness the bottom two absolute changes in their share prices belong to insurance sector. Bottom two, 40, this belongs to insurance sector. And 70, this also belongs to insurance. It implies that the remaining two belongs to retail sector. What was the approximate percentage change in the combined share price value of the two retail companies during the given period? I know that the combined share price of the two companies as on 5 June 2006 was 500 plus 150, that is equal to 650, and the combined share price as on 5th June 2007 was 230 plus 575 is equal to 805. So my answer would be 805 minus 650 upon 650 into 100, which is equals to 155 upon 650 into 100. Now one need to be smart enough while calculating all this. If I look at the options, my calculation is 155 upon 650 into 100. Now I know that 155, if this 650 would have been 600, my answer and this 155 would have been 150, my answer would have been 25%. I'm decreasing my denominator, that means I'm increasing my overall value. So if this would have been 600, my answer would have been close to 25%. That is at higher end, that means my actual answer is less than 25%. I can rule out this option, I can rule out this option. It can never be 30% or 40%. Now, we know that 10% of 650 would be 65, 20% would be 130. I can rule out this option. It is not 20%. I know that the answer is 24% now. Simple way, I did not calculate the exact value. I just ruled out the remaining three options which were incorrect. Next. If Chintamani purchased a total of 60 shares belonging to 4 out of the 6 companies, then the maximum possible percentage return that he could realize on these 60 shares during the given period was. Looking at this table, we want to maximize his percentage gain during the given period, and he bought a total of 60 shares among four companies. Look, he gained a maximum of 60% in company C, then he gained 53.3% here, then 40% here, and the next highest is 15% here. So what we'll do, we know that he purchased all the shares in the multiples of 10. So we'll give minimum shares to these remaining three companies, that is 10, 10, and 10 here. And the remaining 30 we'll give here, because here he is gaining the maximum percentage. So now the calculation here would be, I have to calculate the price of these 60 shares as on 5th June 2006, and again I have to calculate the price of these 60 shares as on 5th June 2007, or I can directly calculate the profit also. So price as on 5th June 2006 would be 30 into 200 plus 10 into, I know that 10 is common for the remaining figure, so I can directly take 10 as common, 150 plus 500 plus 175. 150 plus 500 is 650. 650 plus 175 is 825. That means 8250. So this will give me 6000 plus 8250. That means 14250. Now, since I need to calculate only the percentage profit, I won't calculate the final value, rather I'll do it with the profit itself. 30 into 120, the profit itself, I'll calculate it with the smaller values. Again, 10 is common in the remaining cases. So the profit is 80 for company A, 75 for company B, and 70 for company C. So 80 or 75 is 155, 155 and 70 is 225. 225 into 10 is 2250, and this will give me 3 into 12, 36. So 3600 plus 2250, that is 5850. So 5850 is my total profit, and 14250 is my total cost in 2006. So my answer should be 5850 divided by 14250 into 100. Again, I'll try to eliminate options. 0 is cancelled by 0. This is cancelled by 5, I'll get 117. When this is cancelled by 5, I'll get 285. Now, what is 10% of 285? It is 28.5. 20% would be this, that is 57. 40% would be this, 114. I know that this value is 117. That means my answer should be more than 40%. Only one option is there, 41%. Without knowing the exact value, I calculated this because my rest all options are less than 40%. So the answer is 41%. Next, if the shares that witness the highest and the lowest percentage change in their prices belong to the telecom sector, then what was the percentage change in the combined share price value of the two telecom companies during the given period? The highest percentage change and the lowest percent. The highest percentage change is in company C, that means it belongs to the telecom sector. The lowest percentage change is in company D, it belongs to the telecom sector. Total price as on 5th June 2006 is, I can say, 600. Total profit is 160. So my answer should be 160 divided by 600 into 100. This can be very easily calculated.